Hi, I'm Alexander OK, and welcome to episode 11, part 2 of my Japanese lecture in Wolverhampton. Today I'll be looking at the second part of the Command 44, like mini tree, if you will. The Command 44-2 differs from the Command 44-1 mostly by its engine. It uses a HAT 109 engine, which produces 1,440 horsepower, or around 190 more horsepower than the HAT 41. The Ko model, which is the original model, was armed exactly the same way as the Kai 44-1, as in it has two Type 89 machine guns in the nose and two Ho 103 machine guns in the wings. We don't actually have this model in Warthunder though. I'm flying here the Otsumon, which has two Ho 103 machine guns in the nose, and those big producing the wings are its Ho 301 machine guns. These are large 40mm machine guns used for bomber hunting. They use a Kixis ammunition, which gives them a pretty good rate of fire at 475 rounds per minute. But they have a pretty slow muzzle velocity at 245 meters a second, making them quite difficult to use, as we will see here against this AR-2, this speedy Russian bomber. The good point about them is that once you expend all the ammunition, which you'll do rather quickly, there's only 10 rounds per gun. The cannons only weigh 49 kilograms, which means they don't have much of an effect on your speed, as you can see. I'm unable to actually get hits in the AR-2, these are pretty difficult to use. The final model, which we also have in Warthunder, I'll be showing in a quick plate in the video, is the Hai model. This was armed with four Ho 103 machine guns, then leaving the wings and the nose, and the Otsu model, rather, often had the 40mm removed and replaced with Ho 103. You see the... oof, that was close. The 40mm cannons do really rather well against bombers when you can hit them. However, in real life, they were not liked because of their difficulty to use, so they're often removed and replaced with Ho 103 machine guns. So you can see I've used up all the ammunition, and I'm going to show that the airframe remains as maneuverable rather as the Kai 44-1, despite these large cannons in the wings. The other benefit of the Kai 44-2 High model is that it replaces the, as I really can't shoot, it replaces the telescopic sight you can see here in the Otsu model, which is also used in the Ko and the Kai 44-1. With a reflector sight, which if you play a simulator, I imagine is quite nice. The Kai 44-2 actually made up the majority of the some 1,200 airframes that were produced, with the Ko model being about 350 produced, and around 400 for the Otsu, making it about a third of the entire production run, and the Hai being a little over 400. So it's actually the most produced model. The main problem with this is actually a premium plane, I should point that out, not that we need it, it's quite obvious by the tech trip. The problem with the Otsu model, once you've expended the 40mm in the wings, is that with only two Ho 103 machine guns in the nose, it suffers from the same problem as the Kai 43, in that the nose-mounted Ho 103 machine guns are substantially less effective than wing-mounted ones, as we saw from the Kai 44-1, which does have its whole other fuse into the wings. You see, it's been quite a while to actually get shot on that P-39. This is in part because I'm not a fantastic shot, and in part because of the very low rate of fire of the whole one of the three machine guns in the nose. So, this is actually about 20 minutes later in the video, in the match rather, and I cut it down. I'm diving on this last Soviet bomber. They were sort of hanging around base, although thankfully this guy was a gent and actually left his base. You see the D4Y, his plows into the ground. You get a nice wing fire there. I'm pretty sure I missed with, I'm pretty sure that was the whole one of the three machine guns setting the fire rather than the 40mm. Weird bit of, I'm pretty sure there's a corruption in the video there. It's a shame. The fire keeps going, and it eventually collapses as we go off in the ABC. absolutely smashed into the ground there. So I'll be cutting this clip here and moving on to the Kai 44 to high. As you can see, this is still an absolutely fantastic interceptor. Easily able to climb pretty much anything at the same tier. You can pretty much climb at a good 20 degrees at over 300 kilometers an hour. Also easily able to climb Spitfires. It is almost the sort of Griffin engine Spitfire of low tiers, if you will. Now the High has probably the best combat out of all the Kai 44s in its four Ho-103 machine guns. The two in the wings make it substantially better. Although here, you can see it still remains fairly maneuverable, although it does tend to wobble a wee bit. So yeah, I'm baiting this this Spitfire up. And then she'll decide he doesn't want to do that, and I'll loop over for him. But as you can see, this D4Y is coming in for him, and I think he got bail for getting embarrassed by being killed by a D4Y, which it's a shame for the D4Y, but I get a kill. And you can see here that if you're at high altitudes in this plane, you need to keep your speed above 300 kilometers an hour, or you will just sort of wallow in the air like that. So here I'm diving down to give my D4Y friend a little bit of support. I come down in this this hurricane, who seems the most immediate threat to him. Throttling all the way back, you can see this plane can easily do over 700 kilometers an hour without redlining. Get a nice pilot snipe there. I go back up to avoid getting these Spitfires on my tail. I do consider looping over for that other Spitfire, but it probably wouldn't end that well for me, and the D4Y is perfectly capable of maneuvering with Spitfires, providing it's not taking a bomb load. So I loop around, you can see we've got more friends in here anyway, so I don't think there's any worry for that D4Y at the moment, although these two Spitfires are climbing for him. And honestly, I probably should have taken out that Spitfire, but my poor shooting ensures that I don't. I do get a nice crit on him though. This plane is really excellent at booming and zooming, although it can, as you saw earlier, sustain a rolling scissors like I was. Well, I wasn't really doing a rolling scissors, I managed to maintain being behind that P-39 at all times. It can do reasonably well in a turn fight, although I wouldn't recommend turn fighting anything like a Spitfire. So over here I'm actually dithering an awful lot about who to go for. Do I hope the VF-109, the D4Y, or I think it's a Kai-60? Yeah, it's a Kai-61 over there. Here I think I'll go help the D4Y. As I do, I can see that he's on fire and has already been killed, so pretty much good there, so I'm thinking about going to help someone else, but I just get a kill assist from that VF-109, killing that Spitfire before crashing into him, unfortunately. However, I eventually decide I will take out this Spitfire and avenge our D4Y front. You can see the engine is overheated here, so that is the main problem with the HAP-109 engine. See, these Ho-103 machine guns can do work, as I set that Spitfire alight. I believe I cut the video here, because I considered going over to help that Kai-61 kill that Spitfire, which I was going to ask him, but I thought better of it, because he probably won't respond. So anyway, I cut away. That Kai-61 does manage to kill that Spitfire. So I saw, you might have seen earlier, that there was a Spitfire that had landed at A, Tinian. Tinian? Yes, I'm sure it's called Tinian. Island over here, you can just see him down there in the airfield. This here will demonstrate the sort of speed and dive capability of the Kai-44-2. It's really rather good. I should mention that these Ho-103 machine guns, I'm using the air target belts, they can actually take out light tanks from behind. You do need a fair bit of time on target because you don't have that many armor piercing rounds in the belt. As you can see, I'm easily going over 750 km an hour. You can just about hear the speed starting to Red Line, but it doesn't actually go into Red Line, and I quickly take out that Spitfire, although the ground forces are capturing the airfield, so I'm trying to get away as quickly as possible, which you have no problem doing, because this is, I am leading to be moderately fast, but if you go in a straight line, it isn't too much trouble. Anyway, this has been the Kai 44 2. I'd like to thank everyone for watching. Next episode, I'll be looking at the Kai 61. I've been Alexander Lokin. Thank you for watching.